This video discusses nociceptors, and this is kind of a broad class of peripheral receptors that, according to the literature, will depolarize with noxious stimulation. And there are some nociceptors that are for physical stimulation. They're called mechanosensitive nociceptors, and there's some for temperature variation, and that those are thermosensitive nociceptors. But what I really want to do is address the fact that nociception does not always result in pain. We know that nociception can occur with tissue damage or inflammation, but may not result in pain. And the beginning of our understanding of that process means that we've got to take apart two different fibers. One type of fiber are called the C fibers. These are called the chemosensitive nociceptors, and these will depolarize in the presence of altered chemical activity or irritating chemical activity. Some key things about this is that this is the most numerous peripheral receptor there is. It is also the most numerous of all nociceptors. It is the most numerous peripheral sensory receptor of the spine. And it's chronic bombardment of these C fibers, as they're known, that are responsible for things like fibromyalgia, chronic pain syndromes, sympathetically maintained pain, etc. These C fibers are the small, unmyelinated nociceptors. The other group of receptors, when we talk about nociceptors, are the A fibers. And the A fibers are usually those fast fibers. These are the large myelinated fibers. And these are the ones that will fire up into your brain and register pain. So if you step on a tack, the fibers that are going to let you know that the tack is in your foot and that it hurts are the A fibers. C fibers are slower, and they also tend to fire in different areas of the central nervous system. So whereas the A fibers tend to travel in the spinothalamic tract, these are the ones that cross in the cord after synapsing, cross in rexed area 9, cross and hit the spinothalamic tract, travel to the thalamus, and from the thalamus will fire into the parietal lobe, specifically into three places. One is into the post-central gyrus, where pain is registered. The other would be into the area called the insula in the cortex, which will generate increased autonomic response. And the third place that the signals go after the thalamus is into the limbic system. This is all conscious activity because it's suprathalamic, meaning it occurs above the level of the thalamus. What happens with the C fibers predominantly, and since this is the C fibers are the most numerous sensory receptor and the most numerous type of nociceptor these tend to fire up tracts that are known as the mesencephalic tract, the spinoreticular tract, and the spinohypothalamic tract, amongst others. And the important thing to note here is that these C fibers synapse in areas that are two things that are important. One, they are subthalamic, meaning they're below the level of the brain that fires and registers pain. So any of this activity that goes subthalamically is going to create, in this case, autonomic nervous system changes, but no pain. The other thing is that I wanted to mention is that all these centers that I just underlined in yellow are all responsible for autonomic nervous system activity. The literature says that lamina 1, which is the most superficial lamina of the dorsal horn, if I were to draw just a real quick dorsal horn, anterior horns for you right here, these being dorsal, these being ventral. Lamina 1 is out here. Change of color so it stands out. Way out here. It's the most superficial lamina. And we know that these chemosensitive nociceptors fire into this lamina 1 and also into the area just outside of that known as the substantia gelatinosa. And the literature says these areas of lamina 1 are directly connected to the autonomic nervous system centers in the lower parts of the brain. So the key point of this video is that when we talk about nociception, most nociception does not result in pain. Most nociception travels into autonomic nervous system centers. When we talk about nociception and pain, we're talking predominantly about the less numerous large myelinated A fibers.